The most viewed videos in my channel are those about compiling and installing Geant4 in various operating systems. Can I save your time by sharing my working setup on the cloud so that you can simply download the whole setup to your machine and use it without any installation? The problem is that you may use different operating systems. How can I prepare a single solution that works in everyone's operating system? I can do that by packaging not only Geant4 and its application, but also the operating system where they are compiled, for example, Linux. This whole package is called a container. To run my Linux container on your Windows or Mac OS, you need to install a program called Docker Desktop. Docker Desktop also works in Linux, but I recommend another program called Aptainer for Linux users. I'll make another video to talk about that separately. When I update my settings on the cloud, you can use these programs to pull the new container to your machine to benefit from the update. If you want to know more about the idea behind container and how to install Docker Desktop, please check my playlist, Container. Most containers are hosted and shared in a place called Docker Hub. Searching for Geant4 on Docker Hub results in 199 results from different people. The most recently updated ones are surprisingly not based on the latest Geant4 version 11. Apparently, some people still use some old Geant4 versions for their simulation. The Geant4 collaboration also provides an official Docker image containing Geant4 11.0.3, which is about a year old. It includes most optional features such as Qt, GDML, so on and so forth. It also includes all Geant4 datasets, which also makes the image a little too large for sharing. Most Geant4 container images hosted on Docker Hub contains the compiled Geant4 libraries together with the Geant4 datasets. If we remove the optional datasets from the container and include a compiled Geant4 application, users of this container would not have to write and compile their own Geant4 applications anymore. I also include the compilation toolchain in the container, just in case that some users wants to modify the application and recompile it again. Fizzino Gears is such a container. It includes a tiny Geant4 application, Gears, compiled on top of the latest Geant4 11.1.2, provided by the Geant4 collaboration for CentOS 8. It does not include the optional datasets, that's why it is more than 10 times smaller than the official Geant4 container. To run it on your Windows or Mac OS, launch your Docker Desktop and make sure that its icon shows up in the notification area. Then download the zipped gears from its website. Extract its contents to anywhere you like. Get into the folder, you should be able to see a file called docker-compose.yml, which contains instructions for Docker Desktop to pull and run the Gears container. To use these instructions, you need to open a terminal in this folder. On Windows, simply highlight the address bar, type PowerShell, and return. In the terminal popped up, type docker-compose --run --rm --gears and return. If this is the first time for you to run this command, Docker Desktop will automatically download the Docker image from Docker Hub and run the container after downloading. Pay attention to the change of the prompt. It already changed from the Windows prompt to the Linux one. where you can use command geant4-config --help to find out the options to install geant4 datasets. Run the command geant4-config install datasets. The downloading and extracting of geant4 datasets will start. It may take a while as geant4 provides 12 datasets in total. The good news is that this only needs to be done once. The downloaded datasets are saved in gears install geant4 data directory, which is shared by both your local operating system and the container. Once all the datasets are downloaded, you should be able to run gears and get into an interactive geant4 session where you can run the command ls to list the geant4 macro command tree and use cd to get into one of them and use ls again to list its contents. Type exit and return to quit from the interactive session. In the container, you can also cd into the tutorials subdirectory in the gears folder to run an example macro file. Again, everything inside the gears folder can be seen in the local operating system and in the container. You can edit the macro file in your local operating system and run it in the container. When you run gears in the container, its output will show up in both inside the container and the local operating system for your analysis. Now we are in the position to talk about the difference between images and the containers. What's hosted in the Docker Hub are actually container images. Docker Desktop download them to your local disk and create containers from the image locally. Multiple identical containers can be created out of a single image. In this particular example, you can see the downloaded image, Fizeno Gears, in the Image tab. And a running container in the Containers tab. Once you exit from the container will be deleted automatically due to the RM flag we used when we run this container. The image is still there so that you can use it to create a container next time. Note that the size of the image shown in the Docker Desktop is significantly larger than the one shown in the Docker Hub website. This is because the ones saved on the Docker Hub are compressed for faster downloading, while the ones in your local machine are not compressed for fast running. To summarize, we need only 6 steps to run geant4 simulation without compiling and installing geant4. First, install and run Docker Desktop. Second, download and extract gears. Third, open the terminal in unzipped gears folder. Fourth, in the terminal, run docker compose run gears to get into the container. In the container, run geant4 config install datasets for the first time so that you can download the geant4 datasets. And the last, in the container, run the gears followed by any macro file you would like to use to do your geant4 simulation. And that's it.